Anti Nation, how you guys doing today? Hope you have an amazing day. So, we're going to do something a little bit... Okay, let me try to find my voice. We're going to do a little bit something different this time around. We're going to dive into something I actually got in was suggested to me from an Instagram message or DM or whatever we'll call it. And somebody asked me to start reacting to NF. Now, for me, I was like, who the heck is NF? So I went and searched him. I was like, oh, NF, the rapper. So I've heard of NF before, and I always wanted to dive into him and listen to his music. And I never really got around to it. And I was like, well, what better way to do it now than for my channel? And also, this is going to be the first time I ever do a rapper for my channel. So it'd be nice to bring in a new genre to my channel for a change, you know, since I've just been doing a lot of K-pop, a lot of J-rock, a lot of, you know, really that. And, well, and then obviously, of course, like, Dimash and, like, a couple of different various acapella groups. There we go. So, yeah, it's going to be nice to bring in something a little bit different. Like, nice little, and honestly, I mean, I grew up, like, just listening to rap all the time. And so, like, I mean, this is pretty much, like, the epitome of me growing up in high school. Well, I should say during my high school days, all I listened to ever was rap. I mean, that's just what I just was into at that time period. So, it's going to be fun to dive into something like this. So, please bear with me, because this is my first rap reaction, so I'm going to probably really try to pay attention to, like, what the message is for the song, and try to pay attention to the lyrics, and then maybe every once in a while I'll pause to kind of maybe break down some either really clever wordplay, or I'll break down, like, something that I think really hit hard or something like that, or really hit home if he, you know, if he raps something, like, line that's, like, really, really meaningful, and then, yeah, and then at the end, probably do, you know, a little interpretation of what I think came from the song or what he was trying to say in the song, and then match it up with what you guys think of the meaning of the song is, or if you know what he was trying to say. You guys probably would actually know better than me. So, let's go ahead and dive into this. I'm super excited. Time for the first ever rap reaction for my channel. So, NF, what you got for us? Let's do this! I think we're good now. I think we're good. I think we're ready. I think we're ready. Got captions on. Ready for us. Let's go. Yeah. Okay, we go. Okay, so he's pushing a shopping cart with balloons. Okay. Oh, you're pushing through the grass there, buddy, so I don't know how well it's gonna go. Just saying. What's up, NF?
Hey, Nate. How's life? I don't know. It's all right. I've been dealing with some things like every human being and really didn't sleep much last night. I'm sorry. That's
okay.
Right. I just think I need a little me time. I just think I need a little free time. Little break from the shows and the bus rides. Yeah. Last year I had a breakdown. Thoughts telling me I'm lost, getting too loud. Had to see a therapist and I found out something funny's going on up in my house. Yeah, started thinking maybe
I
should move out.
Like the,
you know, pack
usage
my car,
the,
take
like,
a new
orchestra.
Route, clean up my yard, get
That's
the noose
cool.
out, hang up my heart, let it air out. I've been searching. What does that mean, Nate? I've been
wow.
learning. Grabbing my keepsakes, leaving
Dang.
My burdens. Well, I brought a few with me. I'm not perfect. Looking at the view like this concerns me, picking up the cues, right? I'm quite nervous, hating when I lose sight. Life gets blurry and things might hurt me. It's probably gonna be a long journey, but it's worth it though.
Oh my
world
gosh.
Out there, kid, grab your coat. It's been a minute, I know.
Oh my gosh, this is crazy. I just realized this is, wow, this is madness. Like, every time, like, he does, those are what I call a, big, massive, wow, my brain just totally just stopped working. A massive, like, hit effect. I'm trying to remember what the hell. I don't remember what they. I don't remember what we call them in the EDM world. I'm like blanking so hard. But yeah. Like, if you tell, let's see. I don't know where to go back to. This is interesting, guys. So okay, so NF. So based off of them, based off of him saying Nate. It's my guess is that probably means that his first name is Nate, So he's using N, and then maybe F is probably, I guess, his last name. So he just decided to use his initials, which is kind of cool, actually, because, I mean, NF sounds like an artist name. It's literally just initials for his name, and it sounds like a sick rapper name, so it works really well. I'm assuming that's what it is. I might be wrong, but I'm assuming that's what he's doing based off of how he's... Because it's almost like it almost looks like he's rapping and, like, talking to himself, almost. Like, and I can't really tell from, like, the lyrics yet, like, what he's, like, rapping about, like, with himself. Maybe he's, like, doing, like, some, like, almost, like... It's like he's doing some third party. He's doing some like third person type stuff where it's like he's rapping about himself, but he's talking to himself at the same time. It's like he's breaking the fourth wall in a way, almost, by talking to himself, maybe? I don't know. This is very interesting. I've never heard rap like this before, so I'm very confused, but I'm all for it. So if I just want to show you guys, like, watch what my point of actually pausing was to say that if you watch, every time he gets a big hit, like, massive, like, EDM hit in there, like a doom, like, he starts rapping more intensely and more intensely. So, like, let's see, maybe, like, right around here, maybe this will work. Let's see. Breakdown. Thoughts telling me I'm lost, getting too loud. Still a little bit calmer. And I found out. They're still kind of calm. Going on up in my house. Yeah, started thinking maybe I should move out. You know, pack my car, take a new route. Clean up my yard, get the noose out. Hang up my heart, let it air out. There, I've been searching. What does that mean, Nate? I've been learning. Grabbing my keepsakes, leaving my burdens. Well, I brought a few with me. I'm now a little bit more intense. Looking at the view like this concerns me. Picking up the cues, right? I'm quite nervous. Hating when I lose sight. Life gets blurry and things might hurt me. It's probably going to be a long journey, but there it is. It's worth the dumb cold world. Yeah, the orchestra's getting more intense. Been a minute, I know now I'm back to wrong. Looking for the antidote to crack the code. Pretty vivid, I admit it, I'm in classic mode. Don't need pity given to me, but I can't. Dang, condone. He's so good. To me, wow. I'm cracking nose for cracking jokes. I'm looking for the map, the hope. You see, they're making a whole lot of changes. Wrote a song about that, you should play it. I get scared when I walk on these stages. I look at the crowd and see so many faces. Yeah, that's when I start to get anxious.
Okay,
that's when my thoughts can be dangerous. That's when I put on my makeup and drown in self-hatred, forget what I'm saying.
Where the beat go? Oh my god,
wait, I had to do that again. That was disgusting. Just like, wait, where the beat go? Ball, oh, let's go. That was amazing. Oh my god. Okay, so here, so he's kind of talking about here, like, okay. So, been a minute, I know now I'm back to Rome. So it's like been a minute, maybe. So like maybe it's been a hot minute since he released music. So like maybe this is like a like a song that like is like a first song from him in a while. So he's like, oh look, I'm back, and he's like, pretty vivid, I admit it, I'm in classic mode. So he's like, I'm back, but I'm still in the same mode as I was before. You know, cracking jokes and stuff, goofing around. Maybe he's kind of got like a little bit of a jokester type of like rap flow in some other songs. And then he's like, oh, yeah, see, he's like, oh, I wrote a song about that. You should go listen to it and be like, you know, oh, I wrote this other song. Go check that out, too. Like, almost kind of like self-promoting, you know? And then, see, that's when I put on my makeup. Okay, like, maybe put on your makeup. Like, oh, that's when I, like, it's almost like instead of him being Nate, that's when he puts on his mask and he becomes NF. And he's now officially, like, him as a rapper or whatnot. And then he's like, see, like, kind of playing off of that. He's like, oh, wait, where'd the beat go? Like, wait, NF's like, wait, where'd the beat go? And it's like, boom. He's like, now it's back. Now I'm going to rap my ass off, you know? It's great. I think, you know, like I said, my interpretation is going to be based off of, like, me just purely, like, going off of, like, my own thoughts of what I'm thinking he's rapping about. And I might be totally off. So if I am, please forgive me. It's just me having my opinion. And then you guys can tell me in the comments, like, if, like, how wrong I am, and you can tell me what it really is about. But okay, let me go back one, so then that way I can, like, have it be like, all right, boom, and then he just starts going off, and that's so cool. Oh, this is so great. Dang. Oh, this is bringing back good memories of, like, when I just listened to some great rap back in the day. This is, like, this is next level, though. Like, he's so good. This is amazing. Okay.
That's when I put on my makeup and drown in self-hatred, forget what I'm saying.
Oh, that's what it is.
Where'd the beat go?
Oh! Drums came in, you ain't see that coming.
I did not, you're right.
Head, can't tell me nothing, got a taste of the fame, it'll pull my stomach. Throw it back up like I don't want it. Wipe my face, clean up my vomit. OCD trying to push my buttons, I said don't touch it. Now y'all done it. I can be critical, never typical. Intricate with every syllable, I'm a criminal. Intimate but never political, pretty visual. Even if you hate it, I make it feel like you're in it though.
Oh my gosh, the freaking wordplay. That's insane. Oh my gosh. So it's like, oh my goodness gracious. Oh my, okay, I'm just gonna have to play it and try to, like, go, like, with him. Because, like, I can't really, like, it doesn't show me all the lyrics as I, like, skip through, I don't think. So, like, what, just this wordplay is insane. Oh my gosh, this wordplay is incredible. So, okay, let's. Back up like I don't want it. Wipe my face, clean up my vomit. OCD trying to push my buttons. I said, I don't touch it. Now y'all done it. I can be critical, never typical. Intricate with every syllable, I'm a criminal. Intimate but never political, pretty miserable. Even if you hate it, I make you feel like you're in it though. You call me what you want, but never call me forgettable. Leave you deep in thought, I can never swim in the kiddie pool. Waited, I've been thinking the cinematic is beautiful. Man, I don't know if I'm making movies or music videos.
Yeah, the sales can rise. Doesn't mean much though when your health declines. See, we've all got something that we try.
That's powerful right there. Like, to say, where the lyrics go? There they are. Oh, it's not gonna work. But to say, like, you know, being an artist is like one of the most, it's one of the most amazing and wonderful things to do with your life. But the problem is, it's like when, like, being a musician, being a producer like me or anything like that comes with its downfalls, because there's so much pressure behind that to not only make the best music out there, but you're making it for other people sometimes. Like, I say sometimes, like, for someone like me, I'm making music in hopes that people will actually listen to my music and like me for, you know, what I'm making and like, you know, the music I have to put out in the world. But for someone like NF here, where my guess is this song is probably something where he's pretty well established already, or at least, you know, established enough that he has a pretty good following. So he's basically out there saying, you know, I now have all this pressure on me to impress you guys because I have this huge, huge fandom now that's expecting me to put out just basically golden stuff, like basically just gold and whatnot. So the problem is that kind of pressure, though, can take toll on your mental health. And that's why they always say, like, the people that are out there who have, like, that artistic value are musicians, actors, rappers, you know, producers, you know, whatever you might do, they have so much pressure on them, and they sometimes end up having really bad mental health. And I've seen that with even YouTubers. Like, some of my favorite YouTubers out there I've seen have to take breaks for a whole 2 months and end up sometimes even in therapy just to try to get themselves back on track so they can keep doing what they love. And it's so cool that he's actually self-aware of that, to the point where he knows how – the fact that you're – because that's the first thing you have to start with, being self-aware that you have this issue, if you want to call it that. Even though I don't really like to talk – it's hard for me to talk about mental health because I've dealt with it myself. I don't really like to call it what – like, because really, when you talk about mental health, it's always like mental disorder. And I hate saying that because it's not really a disorder. We just – you know, we just all have grown up and have different, you know, either traumatic events – or we've had different experiences in our lives that have caused our brains to go through that trauma, if you will, and like that, you know, disorder. And, you know, we all are affected by it. That's just how it is. You know, for me, like, I've dealt with ADHD, I've dealt with depression, I've dealt with anxiety and whatnot. It's all come from, like, you know, like, I grew up a very happy child. I was very lucky and very blessed for that. But, you know, there's events in my life that led to that, and, you know, it changes your chemicals in your brain. You can't really do much about that, you know. But for him to be self-aware of that to the point where he's like, okay, I love being a rapper. I love having my fandom, but I also need to make sure I take care of myself, you know, and being, you know, basically saying, like, you know, see what I'm going through. You're not alone, kind of thing is what it's almost like. So, yeah, for rap stuff, I'm probably going to be talking a lot more. So if you guys are not a big fan of, like, a lot of talking and evaluating and stuff like that, then my channel might not be for you. And that's okay. If my channel's not for you, I understand completely. But if you, like, really like the – like, if you like reactors who really kind of try to break down stuff and interpret lyrics and really, really get into the music and whatnot, that's who I am. So just to let you know. All right, so let's keep going. Where we at?
The kiddie pool. Wait, I've been thinking the cinematic is beautiful, man. I don't know if I'm making movies or music videos. Yeah, the sales can rise. Doesn't mean much, though, when your health declines. See, we've all got something.
When you get more popular,
your
sales go up. More pressure.
You
know, and yourself
to hold it underwater, but it always survives. And it comes up out of nowhere like an evil surprise. Then it hovers over you to tell you millions of lies. You don't relate to that. Must not be as crazy as I'm. The point I'm making is the mind is a powerful place. And what you feed it can affect you in a powerful way. It's pretty cool, right? Yeah, but it's not always safe. Just hang with me. This will only take a moment, okay? Just think about it for a second. If you look at your face every day when you get up and think you'll never be great, you'll never be great. Not because you're not with the hate, we'll always find a way to cut you up and murder your faith. Take a look at the benefits. Nothing to meddle with, I can never be delicate. My irrelevant, that depends how you measure it. Take a measurement to back it up and give me the evidence. Pretty evident, dependable can never be tentative. I'm a gentleman, depending on if I think you're genuine. Pretty elegant, but not afraid to tell you to get a grip. Proper etiquette, I keep it to myself when I celebrate.
Oh, man.
It's that time again. Better grab your balloons and invite your friends. Seatbelts back on, yeah, strap them in. Look at me, everybody, I'm smiling big. On a road right now that I can't predict. Tell me, tone that down, but I can't resist. Y'all know that sound, better raise your fist. The search begins, I'm back, so enjoy the trip.
Yeah. So I was right. So this was like one of his first songs after taking probably like a little hiatus, but I bet. Dang. I feel like we have more left, don't we still? Oh, okay, so we have a minute still, and it's like the song's over. So what are you gonna do? I mean, he's not wrong. His music videos actually look very cinematic. So I'm very impressed. So okay, interesting. Okay, I think I have maybe an idea of what the meaning behind the song is. I just want to make sure I'm not going to miss anything. Wow, that's beautiful. That's cool. Dang, where'd he go to film this? That's so, so cool. Also, there's this person out here back in the back here keeps walking. Okay, so he got in the cart. He's hiding away. There's gotta be probably some meaning behind the balloons. Oh, now here's the white person giving him clothes? Looks like? Interesting. I don't know if that's like some kind of like meaning for like the next song. Or like maybe there's like, or maybe there's like, a, I should say like a next video for this song. Maybe? I don't know, that's interesting. Okay, that was dope. Oh my gosh. Okay, let me come talk to you guys about this. So, excuse me, that was amazing. First of all, just for him, first I'll start off with him and just in general, and then I'll dive into a nice little brief synopsis of what I take away from the song. So for him, as a rapper, phenomenal flow. The production is really cool because, like, usually it's like, you know, when you listen to rap, you're expecting, like, hard-hitting, huge, massive subs, and, like, you know, it's like, he's like just, or I should say, massive subs, big, like, you know, the, you know, like cymbals in there, big, huge kicks and like snares and stuff like that. Like, you know, stuff like that. I can't be boxed, forgive me, but you know what I mean. Just trying to kind of show you guys what kind of thing I'm talking about in my head. But he was like, it's like he was like, I'm gonna take an orchestra. And, like, instead of, like, big, like, massive 808s in between the song, I'm gonna use these big, massive impact hits, and, like, that's gonna be my transitions in the song. You know, because, like, it doesn't really, it's like, it looks like he doesn't really have, like, a chorus. It's like, the way he does his raps, it's like he's telling a whole story, and just, like, the progression of the story is, like, brought about with just, like, him, like, because, like, you can see, like, how he progressively, it's like, you know, when he first started out the song, he was like, okay, just rapping, and then a big impact, and then a little bit more heavier, like, more aggressive, a big, another big impact, getting more aggressive, and then just, like, you know, pretty aggressive, but then he's like, wait, where'd the beat go? And he's like, oh, and just goes, and just goes off, and just starts rapping like crazy, and then he kind of dies back down again, into a little bit more of, like, a calmer kind of voice, and then couple more big hits with the orchestra, and then he's like back into it again, like, oh, and just like, oh, here we go, this is what I'm gonna say next, blah blah blah, you know. And like, oh my gosh, like the delivery he has is so good. His delivery combined with his flow combined with his lyrics and the way he writes and the rhyme scheme and bouncing off how he bounces his words off of each other, so impressive. Like, honestly, he might be one of the best rappers I've heard in a while. So in terms of the actual song, though, because it's called The Search, I'm almost wondering, like, is that, like, because the way he's rapping, it's almost like he's talking about almost like a,
it almost was like almost like a little synopsis of like maybe like his career so far, because he's talking a lot about like, you know, looking internally and like saying like, oh, my sales are going up, but you know, just because my, you know, because of sales. It's almost like his hiatus was because he's almost reflecting like maybe why he's on a hiatus in this song. He's saying, oh, I'm trying to, you know, I'm searching for myself, trying to figure out, okay, my sales are going up, my traction's going up, I'm getting more fandom or more fans, and that's great, but it's not helping my mental health. So I had to take this break to really take the time to evaluate myself. And, you know, it's almost like his whole entire rap here is like, you know, almost like a like rap talking to himself, saying like, oh, this is what, it's almost like he's talking to himself and doing like inner soul searching, but he's also telling us, this is why I took a break. This is where I'm at right now. You know, don't worry about me. I wasn't, you know, I know like my mental health might not be the best, but I'm going to be okay. And this song is just to clarify that I am back. I'm not going away anytime soon or anything like that. Here's more music. And I'm sure this is probably like maybe like the main track for like probably a new album or something like that. So that's kind of like what I'm getting away from it. You guys have to let me know, like, if there's actually like a true meaning behind this song. You have to let me know in the comments, or like what you guys' interpretation of it is. So yeah. But as for my first ever reaction to NF, that was awesome. So I'm definitely excited to dive into more stuff. So also, make sure you guys recommend which else you think I should react to from Mr. NF here, because I'm so ready to dive into more of his stuff. Like, he's gonna be real fun to like dive into. I can tell it's he's something special. I can already tell just from this one song. So yeah, I'm excited. All right. Besides that, guys, also, because you're probably new to my channel, since it's my very first reaction to him, go ahead and take that opportunity to like, subscribe, make sure you click on that bell notification to be alerted whenever I start a new group, new band, or new artist like Mr. NF here to my channel. Besides that, you guys are awesome. I love you guys. And as always, bye.